So I'm not a model, and I probably never will be one because of my height. I'm 5'1". But over the past year, I took my photo every single day to find my personal style, and I posed a lot. So in that time, I really figured out how to pose for my body style and how I just feel confident. So I just want to show you some of my tips and tricks that I've learned along the way, and I really hope they help. So first, I'm going to go through some initial tips, and then I'm going to go into like facial poses, because that matters too. And then I want to show you my actual go-to poses that I personally use. So first, I cannot recommend enough to stand up straight in a photo. It's going to make you look so much taller and just more poised. And the best way that I can describe this is I pretend that I'm 6 feet tall. I like to pretend that there is a string that is just holding me up like a marionette. And this is just really good for your health too. Posture is really connected with even how confident you feel. It's so cool to see that connection. And it comes through in photos. Next, I like to keep my limbs away from my body. If that makes sense. I want to keep my arms away from my torso, and I want to keep my legs separate if I can, because then my arms are going to look a lot more slimmer. I also like to keep my legs looking elongated, and so anytime that I can keep my legs a bit separate, it's going to really help. Next, going along with that idea of keeping my arms away from my body, I want to create angles. I want to not look too stiff. If I look stiff in a photo, it's going to look like I'm not that confident. But if I just own it and I'm a little bit more confident just by creating some angles with my body, it's going to really help. And just trying to keep things a little bit loose and natural is so important. Next, it's really important if you want to look taller in a photo that the photo is taken down lower. So kindly ask the person who's taking your photo at Disney World to just like crouch down because that will make you look a lot taller. Or if you have a tripod set it up to where it's probably like hip height would be really important. Imagine the reverse of that. If someone is towering above you taking your photo, you're not going to look taller. So if you want to look taller in a photo, be sure that your photo is being taken down lower. Okay, on to facial expressions. This is something that I always do. I notice it when I'm talking on a video like this, but a lot of times I'll talk and like there's a total double chin happening here. And I don't know why, I'm working on it, but I just kind of naturally do that when I talk. When I'm in a photo, I really try to be intentional with this. It's so easy too. So instead of keeping my head kind of up and my chin back, it's really important in a photo to be able to put my shoulders kind of back. That already is gonna help. And then I just try to keep my head closer to the camera. And then I try to just look down, or I can still like keep my eyes on the camera, and that looks great too. As long as I'm thinking about having my chin downward, then that's gonna really help. That's also gonna help too to not show so much nostril. Like anything that's more flattering will be if your head is pointed a little bit downward. While you're pulling your chin downward, it's important to not push it back into your neck, because that's going to still have that like chin thing that's going on. So if you just keep it kind of outward and down, then you're going to elongate your neck. You're going to look completely flattering and long and elegant. Next is the squinting technique. Even though I like my eyes to be the focal point of my face by adding makeup more so on my eyes than anything else, that doesn't mean I want to have really wide eyes in a photo. It can be a bit creepy or off-putting. And it's a lot more elegant and even chill if I don't do that and I sort of squint my eyes. So it should be not like I'm squinting because it's too bright out, but if I just like try to focus on squinting the inner part of my lower lids, then it gives me a little bit of like smolder. But not over the top either. Play with that and see what you think. Take some selfies and really figure out what works best for your own face and your eyes. So guys, the timing of this could not be more perfect, but there is a flock of ducks that are outside my window right now and they are quacking and it's the cutest thing. The reason why I say that is because my next point is the duck face. Honestly, like there are ducks outside, that's just the weirdest thing. But the duck face is something that's abused online, like you know, when you pucker your lips really a lot and it's trying to look like a cute kiss, but I don't know, it's just not the most flattering all of the time. And sometimes it just looks like it's trying too hard. A better way to do that is more of a cool smirk slash, you know, just trying to do a small pucker has a really nice effect. And you can see side by side, sometimes, like, I can't even do this with a straight face to do a duck face, but if you just try to kind of tone it down, you can still kind of get the same vibe that you were looking for with just a very, like, cool tone. So I want to talk a little bit more about a smirk. So you don't want to look conniving and devious with a smirk like the Grinch, but you also don't want to look like you're upset. It's actually funny because sometimes in my photos, if I'm not thinking about it and someone takes a candid photo of me, I can look kind of upset just because when I'm not like smiling and present on camera, sometimes like my face will just kind of be like, And I'm not being sad at all. That's just kind of how my face is. So I try to smile and everything a lot more. But one nice way to do that on a picture is to be able to just kind of have a little bit of a smirk. To just think, I'm happy. Like, I'm content. And that comes across on camera. Next, a smile that's too big can be really off-putting too. It might look like someone who's just really happy, or it might look like, okay, what's going on here? And so you want it to be something that is more genuine. There's been studies done actually on what type of photo in advertising does really well. And that one's more of like a gregarious, just kind smile. And so if you can kind of tone that down and create a smile that just feels very natural, like you're not super excited to go on the next roller coaster ride, but you're like chill, like that's cool, you know. You know, that's the type of vibe that you want to give off in a photo. And sometimes that'll mean with teeth showing, but it might be something where you just have your teeth not showing and your lips closed. I do that a lot more so in photos, is I'll have like no teeth showing. Okay, so now I want to show you guys how I actually pose. These are like my go-to poses. So for this first pose, I try to just figure out kind of what works with what I'm wearing. The shoes I'm wearing and the pants and, you know, how everything fits is really important. So for something like this, I want to definitely take advantage of how my pants can lengthen my legs. My go-to pose is something like this, where I'm putting most of the weight on the back part of my leg. I don't put any weight on what's toward the camera. So already that just slims everything down a lot and looks really flattering in these pants. Another thing that I try to do is point my knee and figure out how I want that to look. So this can look a lot different than something like that. And then I just kind of lean back. So if I was up front like this, wouldn't have the same effect as if I'm kind of leaning. And then I just kind of figure it out, and I mean, it depends a lot on what you're wearing, but the principles are kind of there, so. And then from there, I can just figure out how I want my hands. Something like this would be really good if the pants are just not really flattering my thighs as much. I can do something like that, or I can just kind of be slouchy with it. There's just different things, and whatever I feel is most confident is what really matters. So sometimes I'll even like play with my fingernails a little bit, and that's just kind of a fun look too. And that kind of helps too if in my photo I want to like highlight any jewelry on my hands or bracelets or anything. That'll work a lot. Otherwise, I can do something like back pockets is good. I don't mind shrugging so much with this, but anytime I can put my shoulders back is a good thing. So next, if you just really want to stand straight on, you can, I mean, but there's different things that I would do for that. So I like it if my legs are a little bit further apart. I like to have my toes a little bit at an angle. I would never, you know, do that. I wouldn't even necessarily go straight on like this, but just like having a little bit of an edge that actually pushes a little bit of my weight on one hip, even though I'm standing straight on. Then from there, I can just kind of figure out what works. What looks cute with the outfit. Bending a knee can help a little bit. Just playing with it until you see kind of what works for you. You also can like play with your body movements to like trying to create angles again. That can be kind of fun too. So if I add a bag or just any prop, that can really help to elevate a straight on look. So here I've got just something like that. But then also the other day I kind of posed like this where I'm creating angles again, and just kind of a fun flirty way to give a vibe of an outfit that wasn't there before. So really what I think this bag is doing is it allows me to kind of slim my legs down a little bit. So this part is my widest point, and I can just kind of go like that, and then the attention isn't my hips, it's this really cute bag. But I can still add like curves to my body by like doing the hand raise thing. So that was kind of why I posed that way the other day. Kind of worked for the outfit I was wearing. Having the bag also just makes it the third piece that a lot of people talk about. So if you have three pieces to your wardrobe, basically including an accessory or a hat or a coat, cardigan, anything like that will make your outfit look more put together, especially in photos. So next, I wanna show what it looks like when I'm doing something a little bit more unique. I'm going to do like a Z shape. So I've got like this angle here and then this angle here. So then I just kind of play with how that looks. I don't have to do that with this arm too, because that would be kind of posy, which is okay to be posy sometimes, but sometimes you don't want it to be over the top. So I like to play with just like my button or do something like that where it's a little bit more casual. Then I just like to figure out where I want my foot placement. Depends on my shoes and how well balanced I am at that moment. And from there, I like to also just tilt my head around, figure out where feels like the most confident, most comfortable, and real way of posing. So, you know, it's still me. I'm just holding my arms and legs a little different, but I want my personality to come through. So if I tilt my head a little bit, or, you know, sometimes you guys know I like to floof my hair. So I like to just kind of do that because that's just how I feel comfortable. And that's what's most important out of any pose is just, do I feel comfortable? Do I feel confident in the way that I'm standing? If it feels too structured, then you'll lose that effortless look about it. One more final note is that these are the things that I realize are the best ways I can pose for my body style, for the clothes that I decide to wear. So definitely, I can't encourage it enough, take your photo every single day, and that'll help you figure out your best clothing options, the best colors that look great on your skin, the best ways to pose it and rock the outfit. Okay guys, I hope this video was super helpful. It was so much fun to put together, and I am going to be out all next week, but I am going to return from vacation and I'm going to continue to post hopefully 3 times a week. And so don't forget to subscribe and tell me what your tips are for how you pose in front of a mirror or in front of a photo. And I'll see you guys in a week. Bye.